And the next item of business is an urgent question, and I call Russell Findlay.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. To ask the Scottish Government what its response is to reports from the Scottish Police Authority that 386 cases of potential drug driving cannot be prosecuted because of major delays in forensic testing.
Cabinet Secretary Keith Brown.
I was first notified of potential capacity issues last year, and in October last year I authorised an urgent additional funding of £325,000. In late April this year, the Government was alerted to a significant number of cases that had not been processed in time for the Crown to take further action, and I instructed my officials to urgently work with the SPA, Police Scotland and the Crown to assess the scale of the issue and determine what immediate and longer-term mitigations were needed. Further exceptional funding of £370,000 was released earlier this month, and I fully support a commission from the SPA for HMICS, Her Majesty's Inspectorate of Constabulary in Scotland, to undertake a formal review.
Russell Findlay.
Thank you. 3 years ago, Hamza Yousaf staged a PR event alongside a police officer at which he said, and I quote, "The police are ready, they have the tools necessary, and if you are caught, there will be a zero-tolerance approach and you will face some hefty consequences." The police were indeed ready, except we now discover that the tools were broken and that hundreds of drug drivers face no consequences for recklessly endangering others on our roads. We know the SNP are great at announcements, not so good on delivery. So what is the Cabinet Secretary doing to now fix this? And will he reconsider his planned police budget cuts, which risk making such failures more likely in future?
Cabinet Secretary.
First of all, I think I've mentioned the additional financing which has been provided to the SPA. That involves both a series of tranches of additional funds in terms of resources, but also additional capital expenditure. And it is true to say, of course, that the estimates for this, how many likely cases would be, was formulated by Police Scotland, the SPA, and the Crown Office, people that are much more expert than this than me. I can't do an estimate of how many cases it's likely to be. So, and it's also true to say the police and the SPA and the Crown Office will say that it's been an underestimate. There have been nearly double the number of tests have been done and people coming forward with positive tests. So they're the experts, they do that. They're also independent. I don't know whether it's the case that Russell Findlay accepts the fact that they are independent. But we will do the two things which are required of us. First of all, to bring forward, to give them the legislative tools they need to do this, to make Scotland a safer place, which they have done. And of course, this is a serious error. The SPA have said that themselves. They'll have their full meeting on Thursday to go over this in more detail. This is a serious error. But they have had the legislative tools in order to allow the police to make these stops and also to get people tested for drugs. So that's made Scotland's roads safer, but they have to correct this. So we have also seen the commitment from the SPA to get HMICS to investigate what more can be done to make sure this can be fixed now and into the future. So it's the right thing to do. And in terms of resources, of course, the budget cut, I think that Mr Findlay should have mentioned, is the 5.2% budget cut that we've had from Westminster, his colleagues, the Tories in Westminster. The police had the protection of the resources budget last year, and I'm pretty sure there was no amendment from the Tories seeking further budget for the police last year. We'll see what happens this year, though.
Russell Findlay.
Thank you. I won't bother addressing the Cabinet Secretary's creative accounting. However, three of the dropped cases involved someone being injured. Can the Cabinet Secretary explain whether those injured people have been told that their case was dropped? And if not, will he commit to now doing so? Can he provide Parliament with a detailed breakdown of each of the 386 cases and indeed apologise to the victims and all law-abiding road users who have been endangered by this incompetence?
Cabinet Secretary.
I'll note the point that's made about incompetence by Russell Findlay. Can I say, first of all, the three cases that he mentions, I don't have the full details on that. This is information held, of course, by the Crown Office, but I do know that in one of the cases, and possibly the other two cases, the injury was self-inflicted, didn't involve a collision with another vehicle. I'm happy to provide more information about the figures. I've given them the figures. It's taken some time to get those definitively, as and when we get that from the SPA and also from the Crown Office, because they are the only ones that will have the information on the stage which they are at in a prosecution process for reasons which I'm sure he's aware with. So happy to provide that information when it comes forward. There's no creative accounting. 5.2% cut to this government's budget. That is, despite that happening, we have protected the police resource budget last year. In fact, I think in the last two or three years, we have given more to the police than was even asked for by the Conservatives. And of course, we have more police officers in this country, and they're paid higher than they are in the rest of the UK.
And a couple of supplementaries. First, Audrey Nicholl.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. It's welcome that the Scottish Government introduced drug driving limits and roadside testing in October 2019. However, we've heard that the demand for forensic testing has exceeded supply. So despite the budget constraints that the Cabinet Secretary alluded to earlier, can I ask what funding the Scottish Government has provided to the Scottish Police Authority to build testing and analysis capacity since the introduction of the new offence in 2019?
Cabinet Secretary.
Overall, £1.9 million has been provided to the SPA since 2018-19 to assist them in delivering testing for the offence, and this funding has been in addition to the core budget SPA receives to ensure the delivery of policing in Scotland. The new offence required new forensic testing machines to be purchased by the SPA, and we provided capital funding totalling £572,000 for these machines. We have also provided over £1.3 million in resource funding through three tranches of funding for outsourcing, including the £370,000 I have agreed to issue earlier this month.
Katie Clark.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. Does this Cabinet Secretary know if there are any other crimes beyond drug driving that are affected by this issue? I understand that in November the government paid to outsource 30% of testing to commercial forensic services to allow about 900 drugs driving cases to be dealt with in this way. Is this a long-term solution, or is the plan to return to an in-house service?
Cabinet Secretary.
Well, the initial intention was to have the in-house service. I should have mentioned that, of course, part of the problem is that the in-house lab used by Police Scotland did suffer a flooding incident which caused problems. It was also, of course, during the course of the pandemic. And so the outsourcing which took place was in deliberate response to that, to make sure that we had the capacity in relation to that. And the part of the investigation by HMICS and the work that we'll do with the SP will be to make sure that we plot out that way forward. And I think the main objective will be to drive out risk that this kind of thing happens in future. As to other crimes, that would really be a matter for the Fiscal's Office to answer on that point.
And briefly, Stephen Kerr.
I know the Cabinet Secretary accepts that the buck certainly stops with him, but I think it was disappointing that in reporting the statistics he did, that he didn't take the opportunity to apologise to the public for what is a massive failure on the part of the whole system when it comes to prosecuting those who have been found to have been driving under the influence of drugs.
Cabinet Secretary.
I'm not sure there's actually a question for me to answer in relation to that, Presiding Officer, but of course I would regret any instance where the opportunity to prosecute a case of drug driving has been lost as a result of the issues that have arisen in SPA forensics. And the whole point is to build on the success which is undoubtedly there, over 5,000 people being stopped that would not have previously been stopped under previous legislation. But of course we want to make sure that every one of those that needs to be prosecuted is prosecuted. And that's what the SPA, and it's not passing the buck, they are independent. I know the Tories have got a hard time getting their heads around this. They are independent, as are Police Scotland, as are the Crown Office. We want to make sure they have all the tools necessary to make sure they can prosecute every case that they have to.
Thank you. That concludes this item of business. There will be a brief pause while the front benches change and we move to the next item of business.